Students, in today's class we are going to see the various industrial gas analyzers. Okay, so already you have studied the gas analyzers in analytical instruments. Okay, condition everything. Okay, so today's class I am going to teach about various industrial gas analyzers. Okay. So in that various gas analyzers, first we are going to see about oxygen analyzer, next nitrogen dioxide, then hydrogen sulfide, okay, then thermal conductivity detectors, okay, those things we are going to see now. Okay. First I'll start with oxygen analyzer, okay, so you see, so gas analyzers are used to determine the quantitative composition of gases. Most of the analyzers are used for the analysis of single component in the mixture. Okay, so some gas chromatography or mass spectrometer, they are meant for multiple component analysis. Okay, so here these are the types of gas analyzers. Okay, oxygen gas analyzers, NO2 gas analyzers, H2S hydrogen sulfide gas analyzer, infrared analyzers, thermal conductivity analyzers. Okay, so first of all we are going to see about the oxygen analyzer. So the determination of oxygen is very important in blood gas monitoring, industrial flue gas monitoring. Okay, so basically there are two methods are used for oxygen measurement. Okay, so first method is nothing but physical method, second method is nothing but chemical method. Okay, so in this physical method it uses the paramagnetic property of oxygen. Okay, so in this physical method it uses the paramagnetic property of oxygen or thermal conductivity. So example of this physical method is nothing but paramagnetic oxygen analyzer. The second one is nothing but chemical method. So in this chemical method it uses the potentiometric and catalytic conversion. Okay, so example of this chemical method is nothing but electroanalytical method. Okay, so last class we have seen the paramagnetic oxygen analyzer. Okay, last class we have seen the paramagnetic oxygen analyzer. So how about the construction of the paramagnetic oxygen analyzer? So in this paramagnetic oxygen analyzer, okay, so which consists of measuring coil, okay, so that is a hot wire. Okay, so you see this is nothing but heated wire. Okay, then as you know here, this is which is having permanent magnet which produce the magnetic flux. Okay, so which produce the magnetic flux. Okay, so this is nothing but a measuring cell. Okay, then gas samples are inserted into this measuring cell. Okay, so here how about the working of this paramagnetic oxygen analyzer, you are going to see now. You see, so as you know, oxygen, nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide, okay, are paramagnetic. Okay, so that means what? They are attracted into a magnetic field. Okay, that is what they are attracted into a magnetic field. Okay, so here oxygen is more paramagnetic than oxygen is more paramagnetic than nitric oxide and nitrogen dioxide. So the above analyzer also called Hayes magnetotherm oxygen recorder, because in this method or in this technique it uses both magnetic and thermal properties of oxygen. Okay, so that's why the name Hayes magnetotherm oxygen recorder. Okay, the gas sample, okay, how about the working? Okay, let me explain, you just listen. So here the gas sample which is to be analyzed is passed through the bottom of the gas cell. Okay, so it contains an electrically heated wire. Permanent magnet provides a strong magnetic field. Okay, so due to the magnetic flux, oxygen is pulled into the region around the hot wire. Okay, so oxygen, it loses its magnetic susceptibility when introduces into high temperature. A flow of gas is proportional to the amount of oxygen present is set up around the wire. Due to this, the temperature of the wire is decreased or cooled and the resistance decreases. Okay, so this resistance is one of the ohm in the Wheatstone bridge. Thus the change in the resistance value is measured, okay, is the measure of the oxygen present in the sample. Okay, so you see, so this is the, okay, so okay, you see, this is the construction diagram. Okay, paramagnetic oxygen analyzer. So paramagnetic oxygen analyzer, which consists of hot wire, okay, then permanent magnet. Okay, so here the measuring sample. Okay, so gases which flows into this measuring cell. Okay, so now what will happen, due to this magnetic flux, what will happen, oxygens are pulled up. Okay, up in a home, what will happen, oxygens are very near to the heated wire, okay, hot wire. Okay, up now what will happen, oxygen which loses its magnetic effect. Okay, now what will happen, that hot wire becomes cool. Okay, so due to that, the resistance value will reduced. Okay, so by changing the resistance value, we can measure the oxygen present in the gas sample. This is nothing but we can say as a paramagnetic oxygen analyzer. Okay, so next one, which is nothing but electroanalytical method. Okay, next one is nothing but electroanalytical method. Okay, in this method, it used to measure the low concentration of oxygen in any sample. Okay, so in this method, it is used to measure the low concentration of oxygen in any sample. Okay, so this setup is called Hirsch galvanic cell. Okay, so you see, so here, how about the construction? So the construction here, that anode is nothing but lead. Okay, so which consists of anode is nothing but lead. Okay, cathode is nothing but silver. Then here the membrane is present. Okay, so you see, so it consists of anode is nothing but, we can say active lead or cadmium. Okay, so it consists of anode, cathode, gas permeable membrane, okay, then porous tube. Okay, so these are the main components of this construction. So anode is nothing but active lead or cadmium, cathode is silver. Okay, silver cathode is present, then gas permeable membrane is present. So what is the use of this membrane? So which separates the galvanic cell from the sample. Okay, so which separates the galvanic cell from the sample. Okay, so next one is nothing but porous tube. This porous tube which is separates the electrodes. Okay, electrodes in the sense what, electrolyte of potassium hydroxide. Okay, so now how about the working? Okay, so when oxygen enters, okay, when oxygen enters the gas, that is the membrane, and it's okay, that gas permeable membrane, and it reduces into hydroxy ion at the cathode. Okay, hydroxyl ion at the cathode. Okay, you see that O2 here in that the cathode, which is reduces to hydroxy ions. Okay, the anode, okay, what is the reaction take place at the anode? Okay, anode lead is reduced into lead 2 ions. Okay, anode lead which reduced into lead 2 ions. Okay, the potassium hydroxide is used to remove any, okay, what is the purpose of potassium hydroxide? The potassium hydroxide is used to remove any acidic substances which are present in the gas stream. Okay, the magnitude of the output current from the cell is proportional to the concentration of oxygen present in the sample. Okay, so by measuring the output current, we can measure the concentration of oxygen present in the sample. Okay, the magnitude of the output current, which is proportional to the concentration of oxygen present in the sample. Okay, so here, what is the action takes place at the cathode? What is the action or what is the reaction takes place at the anode? Okay, then what is the use of potassium hydroxide? Then the magnitude of the output current, okay, which tells the concentration of oxygen present in this sample. Okay, so this is nothing but we can say as a electroanalytical method. Okay, so this electroanalytical method, which consists of anode, cathode and membrane. Okay, so these are the main parts. Okay, so then porosity, which separates the electrodes. Okay, then when oxygen enters, what will happen? That gas permeable membrane and is reduced into hydroxyl ion at the cathode. Okay, so what is the reaction takes place at the cathode? You have to write this equation. What is the reaction takes place at the anode? You have to write this equation. Okay, here anode is nothing but lead. Okay, so lead is reduced into lead to ions. Okay, then what is the use of potassium hydroxide? Okay, this potassium hydroxide is used to remove any acidic substances which are present in the gas stream. Okay, the magnitude of the output current from the cell is proportional to the concentration of oxygen present in the sample. Okay, so this is nothing but electroanalytical method. Okay, those two are analyzed for oxygen analyzer. Okay, next we are going to see about NO2 analyzer. Okay, so in this NO2 analyzer, that is oxides of nitrogen are measured both in ambient temperature and in the gases emitted by the industry. Okay, the oxides of nitrogen or paramagnetic in nature. Okay, oxygens of nitrogen or paramagnetic in nature. Okay, the methods used to determine the nitrogen oxides emitted from industry are given below. Okay, so you see here, these are all the methods. Okay, one is nothing but non-dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer. Okay, next one, chemiluminescent method. Next one is electrochemical devices. Then next one is gas chromatography method. Okay, so these methods used to determine the nitrogen oxides present in ambient air. Okay, so here first one is now here industrial emission monitoring. Okay, so in this industrial emission monitoring it is necessary to measure and control the gases emitted by the various industries and to avoid the pollution. Okay, so why we can go for analysis of toxic gases here? Nitrogen oxide is nothing but one of the toxic gases. Okay, so we want to avoid the pollution. Okay, so that's why we have to analyze the toxic gases also. Okay, so here that's it. So why we are measuring the industrial emission monitoring is necessary to measure and control the gases emitted by the various industries and to avoid the pollution. Nitrogen oxide is attracted by the magnetic field and therefore it is detectable by the paramagnetic analyzer. Okay, so now you see this is the one of the method, so which is nothing but non-dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer. Okay, so here by using this method we can analyze NO. okay, So we can analyze the NO, SO2, CO, CO2, okay? So those things we can analyze, okay? So how can we, okay, how about the construction of this non-dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer, okay? So here, this non-dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer, which consists of photometer, okay, sample cell, then oxygen O2 tank, okay, then control station and recorder. Okay, so what are the main components of non-dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer? Okay, so here this is the block diagram or construction diagram. Okay, so how about what are the main parts or main components? First one is nothing but SO2 sample cell, okay, sample cell, okay, either it will be SO2 or NO2 or NO, okay, so it will be present, okay, then photometer, then oxygen tank, recorder, then control station, okay, these are all the main components, okay, let me see here, okay, the main parts present in the methods of sample cell, oxygen tank, photometer, light source, control station and recorder. Okay, next we are going to see how about the working of this. Okay, so you see this method is mainly used to determine nitric oxide in the sample. Okay, so nitric oxide is nothing but what? NO. Okay, so by using this method we can measure the concentration of CO2, CO, SO2, etc. Okay, so let me start this session. You see here that nitric oxide is transparent to visible and UV rays. Okay, nitric oxide is transparent to visible and UV rays. So nitric oxide, also it is necessary to convert nitric oxide into nitrogen dioxide. Okay, so how can we convert nitric oxide to nitrogen dioxide? By using oxygen tank. Okay, by using oxygen tank. Okay, so this nitrogen dioxide is given to the sample cell, which is illuminated by the light source, okay, the transmitted light is detected by the photometer and it is recorded using the control station. Okay, so you see this is the construction diagram. Okay, so here what is present? Nitric oxide is present. Okay, so nitric oxide is, okay, which is transparent to UV light. Okay, so it is necessary to convert that nitric oxide into nitrogen dioxide. Okay, so for that this is, okay, given to the oxygen, okay, O2 tank, then which converts into nitrogen dioxide. Now this nitrogen dioxide is coming, okay, so which is given to the NO2 sampler, okay, sample cell. So here now light source is present. Now what will happen? So when light source is coming, this NO2 illuminates the light. Okay, so from that we can measure the how much amount of NO present in the gas. Okay, we can measure the how much amount of NO present in the gas. Okay, so like, okay, that is the working of this method. Okay, what is the name of this method? Which is nothing but non-dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer. Okay, so here this method is, once again I am repeating, this method is mainly used to determine nitric oxide in the sample. So nitric oxide is nothing but what? NO. Okay, so it is also detects the concentration of CO2, CO and SO2. Okay, so nitric oxide is transparent to visible and UV rays, so it is necessary to convert nitric oxide into NO2. So for that the NO is converted into NO2 using the oxygen tank. Okay, this NO2 is given to the sample, which is illuminated by the light source. Okay, the transmitted light is detected by the photometer. Okay, the transmitted light is detected by the photometer and it is recorded using the control station. Okay, So this is the working of non dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer. Okay, so next we are going to next. Okay, these are all the advantages. Once again, 1 minute, which is used for frequency analysis. So disadvantage is nothing but expensive. Okay, so next method is nothing but luminescent method. Okay, so what is the okay? Well, how about the construction of this method? You see here, what is the main components present here? First one is thermal converter. Okay, so this one which is used for measurement of NO2. Okay, so our analysis of NO2. Okay, so here NO2, in this method that NO2 must convert it into NO. Okay, for that the thermal converter is present. Okay, so here it consists of thermal converter, then flow meter, then reactor, photo tube, okay, then ozonator. Okay, those things are important components of this method. Okay, so now in this method, okay, let me see here. You see, everyone, listen here. This method, nitrogen oxides are analyzed on the basis of the reaction of the matter in the ozone. Okay, so NO2, okay, here in this method, it is used to analyze the NO2 present in the gas. Okay, so but NO2 reacts with ozone very slowly. Okay, NO2 reacts with ozone very slowly. Okay, so it is reduced into NO using catalytic reaction or by the converter. Okay, this NO is made to react with ozone. This reaction is, that is NO plus O3, which gives NO2 plus it gives plus light. Okay, so from this reaction, that light is emitted. Okay, the light emitted can be measured photometrically, which indicates the presence of NO2. Okay, which indicates the presence of NO2. Okay, so this is nothing but chemi illuminescent method. Okay, so you see, how about this method? Okay, so name of this method is nothing but chemiluminescent method. Okay, so in this method, it is used to measure the NO2 or concentration of the NO2 level. Okay, but the reaction with NO2 plus O3 reaction is, it takes very slowly. Okay, so it is required to convert this NO2 to NO. Okay, for that, which requires thermal converter. So from this thermal converter, that NO2 which is converted to NO. Okay, here now which is coming. Okay, so here flow meter is present, flow meter which controls the flow of the NO. Okay, then you see that this NO plus O3. Okay, so here there will be a reaction is coming. Here this is the reactor. Okay, from this NO is coming, from that O3 is coming. Okay, so here reaction takes place. Okay, so how about the chemical reaction? Okay, that chemical reaction is nothing but NO plus O3, so which gives NO2 plus light emitter signal or light signal. Okay, light. Okay, that light emitted can be measured photometrically, as which indicates the presence of NO2 or which indicates the NO2. Okay, next, okay, what are the advantages of this method? High sensitive photometry, continuous analysis. Okay, then what are the disadvantages of this method? This method requires oxygen generator, then NO2 catalytic reaction is necessary. Okay, so next we are going to see next method, which is nothing but electrochemical sensors. Okay, so permanently installed probe type electrochemical sensors are available for the measurement of NO, NO2, NOx, okay, that is nitric oxides, okay, nitrogen oxides. Okay, these units are microprocessor based and are available with 4 to 20 milliamps transmitter output. Okay, then what are the advantages of this method? So here, simple apparatus, continuous analysis. What are the disadvantages? Low sensitivity. No, okay, NO oxidation is required. Okay, NO oxidation is required. Okay, so another one method is nothing but what? Gas chromatography. Okay, this method is used in very limited applications. Okay, so this process is similar, this concept is similar for already we have seen the gas chromatography. Adhe concept la than here also, which is working. Okay, so next, ambient air monitoring or atmospheric air monitoring. Okay, so here NO is not measured directly, but it measured after oxidizing. Okay, that is NO to NO2. Okay, the NO is oxidized into NO2 using potassium permanganate. Okay, the potassium permanganate or by dichromate or by chromium trioxide. Okay, there are two types of analysis. Okay, first one is nothing but series analysis, second one is nothing but parallel analysis. Okay, so how about the reaction takes place here? So here this is air. Okay, so this air here, which consists of both NO and NO2. Okay, so by next, this one is given to the NO2 analyzer. So by using this NO2 analyzer, we can measure the NO2 concentration. Okay, so concentration of the NO2. Next, this one given to the, okay, next, and after that, what will happen? We are removing the NO2. Okay, then only NO only present. Okay, then we have to oxidize this NO. After oxidizing, that NO becomes NO2. Okay, so now NO2 is coming. So from that we can measure. Next, this one is given to the NO2 analyzer. Okay, so from this NO2 analyzer we can measure only the NO concentration. Okay, so next is nothing but series 2 mode. Okay, so here how about the same thing, air which consists of NO and NO2, then first one which is given to the NO2 analyzer which measures only the NO2 concentration. Next, which is coming next, what will happen? NO mattu enavudhu, okay, NO which is converted into NO2. Okay, so which is given to the oxidizer which converts the NO into NO2. Now NO2 plus NO2 is coming. Next, we are measuring NO2 analyzer. Here we are connecting the NO2 analyzer. Okay, so here which measures the NO plus NO2 concentration, which measures. Okay, so this is nothing but series 2 mode. Okay, another one is nothing but parallel analysis. This parallel analysis, the same thing, air which is given to the NO2 analyzer. From that, here NO2 concentration alone which is coming. Okay, air which is given, okay, here NO plus, NO here, air which is coming. So this one given to the oxidizer which converts NO into NO2. Okay, that NO2 is given to the NO2 analyzer. Okay, so from this we will get NO2, okay, NO plus NO2 concentration is coming. Okay, so now both is given to the one summer circuit, or we can say as a difference, okay, input, okay, difference, okay, here one amplifier kudukom, here which gives the difference between those two concentration, the difference between those two concentration which gives the NO concentration alone. Okay, so next one is nothing but parallel mode 2. So here that air is given to the NO2 analyzer, okay, which gives the NO2 concentration alone. Okay, next, here what will happen? Here air plus, okay, air is coming. So from next, this one is given to the NO2 observer. So NO2 metal observer, so remaining NO only present here. Now this NO is given to the oxidizer. Okay, so now this NO which is convert into NO2. Okay, so next, this is given to the NO2 analyzer. Okay, this NO2 analyzer, okay, which analyze the concentration of the NO2. Okay, NO2. Okay, so from that we can measure the NO concentration. Okay, So that is one of the method. Okay, that is series and parallel method. Okay, so another one is nothing but next we are going to see hydrogen sulfide analyzer. Okay, next we are going to see the hydrogen sulfide analyzer. Okay, so in this hydrogen sulfide analyzer, okay, so here you know that hydrogen sulfide is a colorless gas. Okay, so with your Roton egg order. Okay, so you see that toxic here H2S also one of the toxic gas. Okay, one of the toxic gas. Okay, so this H2S is monitored for personal safety, environmental protection, and process control. Okay, so what are the sources of hydrogen sulfide? Okay, so natural sources are sulfur hot springs. Okay, then lake. Okay, those things. Okay, then here, then what are the industrial sources? Okay, emission from petroleum refineries, then tank farms, then natural gas plants, petrochemical plants, oil sand plants. Okay, sewage treatment plants, then okay, those things. Okay, so you see these are all the sources of hydrogen sulfide. Okay, so how to analyze the hydrogen sulfide? So here there are different types of hydrogen sulfide analysis. Okay, so here one of the method is electrochemical cell. Okay, second one is gold film sensor, third one is semiconductor sensor, fourth one is lead acetate tape staining. Okay, then next one is photometric analyzer. Okay, so first we are going to see the electrochemical cell. Okay, first we are going to see the electrochemical cell. Okay, so in this electrochemical cell, which consists of, okay, you see, which consists of a pair of polarized electrodes. Okay, this is nothing but polarized electrodes. Okay, so which isolated from the ambient air by the gas, okay, by the gas permeable membrane. Okay, so which is isolated from the ambient air by a gas permeable membrane. Okay, so this is nothing but membrane. Okay, this is polarized electrode. Okay, so here this is nothing but indicator. Okay, so you see, as hydrogen sulfide diffuses through a membrane, okay, as hydrogen sulfide diffused through the membrane, an oxidation reaction is take place. Okay, oxidation reaction is takes place. Okay, so and the resulting electrons causes current flow. Okay, the oxidation reaction is takes place, which results in a which cause there will be a current flow. Okay, this current flow, which is proportional to the concentration of the hydrogen sulfide present in the air. Okay, so this is nothing but electrochemical cell. Okay, so how about the construction of this electrochemical cell? This electrochemical cell, which consists of a pair of polarized electrodes. Okay, so which is isolated from the ambient air, okay, by this gas permeable membrane. Okay, so as hydrogen sulfide diffused through the membrane, or okay, as hydrogen sulfide diffuses through the membrane, what will happen? An oxidation reaction takes place. Okay, so which cause there will be current flow. That means what? So because of this oxidation reaction, okay, there will be the flow of electrons. Okay, so because of this electrons, there will be a current flow. Okay, so this flow of current, which is proportional to the concentration of hydrogen sulfide acid. Okay, so hydrogen sulfide present in the air. Okay, concentration of the hydrogen sulfide present in the air. Okay, this is nothing but we can say as a electrochemical cell. Okay, so now what are the advantages of this method? So this method is portable battery operated instrument. Okay, then available in packet size. It won't require any pump to pull the sample, then unaffected by wind. Okay, what is the disadvantage? Disadvantage is interferences of background gases such as hydrogen, carbon monoxide, ethylene, sulfur oxide, chlorine, nitric oxide, and nitrogen dioxide. Okay, these are all the disadvantages. Okay, so another method is nothing but gold flame sensor. Okay, so in this method, it uses the principle of absorption for the measurement of hydrogen sulfide. Okay, principle of absorption for the measurement of hydrogen sulfide. Okay, the concentration is determined by the proportional change in the electrical resistance. Okay, the concentration is determined by the proportional change in the electrical resistance. Okay, the gold flame absorbs the hydrogen sulfide and registers the concentration. Okay, so here gold flame sensor, what is the principle used? It uses the principle of absorption for the measurement of hydrogen sulfide. Okay, the concentration is determined by the proportional change in the electrical resistance. Okay, the gold flame which absorbs the hydrogen sulfide and registers the concentration okay, what are the advantages of this gold flame sensor? First one is available in very small range. Okay, second one, insensitive to interference by SO2, CO2 and CO. Okay, what is the disadvantage? It requires an internal pump. Okay, this is the disadvantage of this method. Okay, another one is nothing but photometric analyzer. Okay, so in this photometric analyzer, so which consists of sample cell, okay, then light source and a photometer. Okay, so these are all the main components. Okay, these are the components of the photometric analyzer. Okay, it consists of sample cell, light source, photometer. Okay, and photometer. Okay, so it uses the principle of absorption of light by the hydrogen sulfide for the measurement. Okay, what is the principle? The principle of absorption of light. Okay, by the hydrogen sulfide for the measurement. When light passes through the cell, okay, so from this light source, okay, light passes through the cell. Okay, the intensity of light reaching the detector, okay, the intensity of light reaching the detector decreases with increase in the concentration of hydrogen sulfide in the sample. Okay, so the intensity of light is decreases, okay, with increases in concentration of hydrogen sulfide. Okay, so from that we can measure the concentration of the hydrogen sulfide. Okay, so here from the light source, light passing through the cell, okay, so the intensity of light reaching the detector which decreases with the increase in concentration of hydrogen sulfide in the sample. Okay, so from that we can measure the concentration of the hydrogen sulfide. Okay, this is nothing but photometric analyzer. Okay, another one method is nothing but lead acetate tape staining. Okay, so in this method, this is also H2S is a toxic gas. Okay, so here how to analyze this method. So first of all, what are the components present in this lead acetate tape staining. Okay, so you see here, so first one is nothing but, okay, so here which is consist of light beam is present. You see here which is nothing but sample chamber. Okay, so first one is nothing but sample chamber. Here this is nothing but reaction window. Okay, so this is nothing but okay, here samples which is coming inside. Okay, so this is nothing but Comedifier, okay, midget, okay, here this one, okay, okay, then light source, okay, these are all, then photocell, okay, these are all the important components of this lead acetate tape stain, okay, sample chamber, okay, reaction window, okay, then this block, okay, that is comedifier, okay, so this one midget, okay, this one, next one light source, then photocell, okay, so here we are using two photocell, one for reference, another for measuring photocell. So from the difference of okay, so from the difference, okay, from the reference, it gives a reference value. So this one which gives the value, which one, that is, which one, that is, when the H3S sample inga varumbodhu enna aagum here, that because of here there will be change in the color, okay, brown color la maarum, okay, appo enna aagum, the light oda intensity vandu change aagum, okay, so from that we can measure, okay, the change in the value da inga record pandrom, okay, from that only we can measure the H3S concentration, okay, so we will see the construction, okay, you see it consists of a comedifier, okay, then tungsten lamp, which is nothing but light source, okay, then sensing tape with the reaction window, sensing tape with the reaction window, photocell, then indicator, okay, so what is the step one, okay, so first what will happen, the sample at a constant rate enters the comedifier where it bubbles through a 5% acetic acid solution, okay, so now the sample then flows through a reaction window of the sample chamber where it is passed over an exposed surface of paper sensing tape with lead acetate, okay, this tape is automatically driven by the motor, okay, next this H3S reacts with the lead acetate to form lead sulfide, okay, which to form lead sulfide causing a brown stain on the paper. The color change is proportional to the concentration of H2S in the sample, okay. The light rays from the source is divided into two beams. One is nothing but reference photocell, okay. Second beam is allowed to react the measuring cell by crossing the reactive window. According to the color depth, the absorption of light varies the tape, varies in the tape. Okay, due to this, the measuring photocell, which detects the light in the variation with respect to photocell. Okay, the variation between the two photocell values is a measure of the concentration of hydrogen sulfide in the sample. Okay, it gives accurate result in measuring the concentration of hydrogen sulfide. Okay. So you see, so this is the construction of the lead acetate tape stain, okay, so you see here sample is entering, okay, this is nothing but comedifier, okay, with 5% acetic acid, okay, in water, okay, now what will happen, inga na aagum appo bubbles varum, bubbles ahi inga vandu, which is coming to this sample is now entering to this reaction window, okay, so here this is nothing but we can say it's a sample chamber. This is nothing but we can say it's a sample chamber, okay, so this sample chamber, okay, so which consists of reaction windows, okay, so here this one is controlled by the motor, okay, so here what will happen, that sample comedifier, okay, this sample is coming here, this sample which includes the H3S, okay, upon what will happen here, which is coming, okay, so now what will happen, you see, so this is the measuring photocell, okay, this is the reference photocell, okay, upon because of present in the hydrogen sulfide, what will happen here, that will be brown color la vandu anga padi, okay, because of change in the color, what will happen, that light absorption, okay, will change, okay, so from that, okay, here which gives the reference value, this one which gives the measuring value, okay, so from the difference in the value, okay, which one? Okay, well, from the difference in the value, we can measure the hydrogen sulfide present in the sample. Okay, that difference value which indicates this indicator. Okay, that is nothing but okay here, which is nothing but indicator. Okay, this indicator which gives the change in the value. Okay, so from this change in the value, we can measure the hydrogen sulfide. Okay, so that is only here which is present. Okay. Okay, allow to reach the measuring cell by crossing the reaction window. According to the color depth, the absorption of light varies in the tape. Okay, so here which is nothing but, you know, this is nothing but tape. Okay, so here, okay, this is nothing but exposed sensing tape. This is nothing but exposed sensing tape. Okay. Okay. So that is nothing but, okay, this method is nothing but lead acetate tape staining. Okay. Okay, next one is nothing but solid state sensor or semiconductor sensor. Okay. So in this method, which consists of heater, okay, then semiconductor film. This is nothing but heater. So this is substrate. Okay. So what are the important components present here? Heater, semiconductor film, thermistor, okay, then contact pads. Okay, those things here just present. You see here, so this one which consists of heater film, thermistor film, and semiconductor film. Okay, so what is the use of a heater? So heater which is used, okay, which is used for maintaining the sensor, maintenance of the sensor in a particular temperature. Okay, the particular temperature is nothing but here 150 to 300 degrees Celsius. Upon high temperature, okay. The resistance of the semiconductor decreases with increase in the concentration of the hydrogen sulfide. Okay, other than the concept, the resistance of the semiconductor decreases with increases with the increase in the concentration of the hydrogen sulfide. The decrease in resistance is the logarithmic function of the hydrogen sulfide concentration. Okay, so here, what are the important points? Components, substrate, heater, semiconductor film. Okay, this is nothing but semiconductor film. Here, this is nothing but thermistor. Okay, what is the use of this heater, which is used to provide the constant range of temperature. Okay, that is nothing but in the range of temperature, it will be 150 degrees Celsius to 300 degrees Celsius. Okay, that sensor always it will be in the temperature range. Okay, so here this is nothing but semiconductor. Okay, here this thermistor is present. Okay, so what is the action carried out here? The resistance of the semiconductor decreases with the increase in the concentration of the hydrogen sulfide. The decrease in resistance is a logarithmic function of the hydrogen sulfide concentration. Okay, what is the advantage? Okay, so it can detect hydrogen sulfide at extreme temperature, because this one which is under very high temperature. Okay, what is the disadvantage? Interference of hydrogen, ethylene, and methane. Okay, so that is the disadvantage. Okay, this is IR analyzer. Okay, next, this is nothing but thermal conductivity analyzer. Okay, so in this thermal conductivity analyzer, okay, this thermal conductivity analyzer works best when the thermal conductivity of the gas to be detected, okay, has an appreciable different value from other gases in the mixture. Okay, how about the working? So here, so this thermal conductivity analyzer, which consists of four chambers. Okay, C1, and you see here, this is chamber 1, chamber 2, chamber 3, and chamber 4. Okay, so chamber 1 and chamber 2 are measuring chambers, chamber 3 and chamber 4 are reference chamber. Okay, first initial here, each chamber, a platinum wire of equal dimension and resistance is exposed to gas. Okay, and these four wires forms a Wheatstone bridge. Okay, which is like a Wheatstone bridge. Okay, so here this C1 and C2 are measuring chamber, C3 and C4 are reference chamber. Okay, so each chamber, a platinum wire of equal dimension and resistance is exposed to gas, and these four wires forms a Wheatstone bridge. Okay, first all the chambers are filled with reference gas. ஓகே அப்போ எவ்ரி திங் விச் இஸ் ரெஃபரன்ஸ் கேஸாக இருக்கும்போது வாட் வில் ஹேப்பன் தட் கால்வனோமீட்டர் விச் கிவ்ஸ் ஜீரோ வேல்யூ ஓகே விச் கிவ்ஸ் நல் டிஃப்ளக்ஷன் ஓகே ஸோ ஆஃப்டர் தேட் ஓகே ஸோ ஆஃப்டர் தேட் நெக்ஸ்ட் என்ன பண்ணுவாங்கன்னா ஸோ ஹியர் விச் கிவ்ஸ் தி ஜீரோ வேல்யூ நெக்ஸ்ட் தட் மெஷரிங் சாம்பர் இருக்கலாம் அதை மட்டும் ஃபில்டு வித் தி கேஸ் ஓகே தி மெஷரிங் சாம்பர்ஸ் ஒன்லி ஃபில்டு வித் தி கேஸ் ஓகே அண்ட் ரெஃபரன்ஸ் சாம்பர்ஸ் ஆர் ஃபில்டு வித் தி ரெஃபரன்ஸ் கேஸஸ் ஓகே ஸோ டியூ டு தி சேஞ்ச் இன் தெர்மல் கண்டக்டிவிட்டி தி ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி பிளாட்டினம் சேஞ்சஸ் ஓகே டியூ டு சேஞ்ச் இன் தி தெர்மல் கண்டக்டிவிட்டி தி ரெசிஸ்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் தி பிளாட்டினம் changes okay it creates what will happen imbalance okay so you see so as I told okay so here c1 c2 are measuring chambers okay those two are c3 and c4 are reference chamber okay first initially everything in a filled with reference gas are filled panipanga so galvanometer which gives zero okay then after that that c2 and c1 okay which is filled with measuring gas okay c3 and c4 filled with reference gas okay so due to the change in the thermal conductivity what will happen the resistance of the platinum will change okay so which indicates okay which gives there will be a change in the reading of galvanometer okay the change in the reading which indicates the change or which gives the concentration of the gas okay which gives the concentration which from that change in the value we can measure the or we can which gives the thermal conductivity of the gas okay so this is nothing but thermal conductivity analyzer this is nothing but thermal conductivity analyzer okay so next one is nothing but what dust measurement okay so in powerhouse it is necessary to control the dust in the chimney in order to satisfy the law of municipal okay initially the amount of dust is monitored by the trained observers from environmental protection agency but this measurement is inaccurate okay so for that we can go for different types of dust monitoring instruments okay so these are all the different types of dust monitoring instruments optical type flow dust monitoring reflector light dust monitoring electrical type flow dust monitoring electrostatic type flow dust monitoring okay so those things we will see in the next class okay okay I think not 2 minutes is it okay so I will revise what are the topics we have seen today okay so I think from Monday onwards you will have the second internal test okay so I have only dust monitoring and smoke the dust analyzer and the smoke analyzer mattum dhaan na edukala okay so those topic if possible I will take in the next week okay eppadi ungalku morning internal test ah irundha afternoon definitely there will be the regular class okay so during the time I will complete those portion okay so you have already studied those topics okay just I will give the revision okay so that it will be very useful for your studies okay so today what are the topics we have covered okay so first we have seen the oxygen analyzer okay one second so first we have seen the oxygen analyzer okay so in that oxygen analyzer we have seen the paramagnetic oxygen analyzer okay then electroanalytical method okay so next we have seen the NO2 analyzer okay so this is for NO analyzer okay non dispersive infrared and ultraviolet analyzer okay then we have seen the chemiluminescent method okay next one we have seen the electrochemical sensors then gas chromatography which is also used for analyzing the gas okay so here NO2 or CO2 analyzer but which is for limited applications so they are using okay then ambient air monitoring system okay this is nothing but atmospheric air analyzing okay here series analysis series mode 1 and 2 parallel analysis parallel mode 1 and 2 then we have seen the H2 yes analyze that is hydrogen sulfide okay hydrogen sulfide is one of the toxic gas okay so what are the different types of H2S analyzer okay electrochemical gold film sensor semiconductor sensor lead acetate tape staining then photometric analyzer okay those things we have seen today okay then solid state, okay, those things, okay. Then we have seen the thermal conductivity analyzer also, okay. So like next class we will see the dust measurement and smoke analyzer, okay. So those things we will see, okay. The concept wise everything is just very easy one. I hope everyone understand today's class. If any doubt